let's quickly go over some highlights from the last 12 months about what Insomnia has shipped. So these are, again, are just some highlights, but starting from the bottom here, we shipped some gRPC support, which is awesome that we were able to do this. So we want to support, you know, more and more protocols. There's definitely more to go on the gRPC front for sure, but we're really excited to bring that to all of you. And we're going to be looking at other protocols as well into the future, like MQTT, WebSockets, and more. We also released a portable EXE for Windows and continue to do so with each Insomnia release. This allows you to just run this executable rather than installing it on your Windows machine, which can be really nice, particularly in some enterprise environments. We also combined the application into a single application. Previously, we had both Insomnia Studio and Insomnia Designer, and we were able to combine those into a single application to make it easier for you to use and not have to switch contexts depending on which use cases you needed to solve at a particular time. We also added theming support, so we have lots of different themes available in Insomnia, and we actually just recently launched the support for syncing better with your operating systems, light mode and dark mode. So definitely check that out if you haven't yet, and get your Insomnia themed the way you want it. The next two items up here are really about the API Ops pipeline that I was talking about, and some of what you already saw in the keynote and other sessions earlier today. But it's really about helping and adding new functionality for the declarative configuration generation that the INSO command line tool uses. So in addition to the Insomnia application that lets you test and debug and design APIs, we also have a command line tool that really is the key for that API ops pipeline, the thing that you can run in CI to run these tests that you build, and again, generate this declarative config generation for Kong Gateway and other products. We also converted Insomnia to use TypeScript. So this is a huge win for us both internally, so we can help develop faster, as well as the community so that you can contribute in a modern application, which we're really excited about. And finally, most recently, we open sourced all of our documentation. So we're really excited about this experience now, that which is kind of rebranded for you, and looking forward to any contributions or issues that you wanna raise there. Definitely please feel free to contribute to both the documentation and the Insomnia products as well. And then finally, as you probably heard in the keynote as well, we just recently launched Insomnia projects. So with projects, it's basically a new container that you can use, which can hold many designs and collections, which of course hold many paths or requests. So with that, I'm going to jump into a demo. We've got the demo here. Here's Insomnia. You may or may not be familiar with it. And here we have all of my different projects that I'm a part of. So each of these ones with the globe next to it is a remote project that is associated with a particular team. So I'm here in this Connect API project currently. And then I can also have local projects, and I can create new local projects if I'm debugging something or developing something on my own, for example. So within this Connect API project, you can see I have different tiles here. And these represent the different services within Connect. Some of the different services within Connect that we have. So if I jump into the runtime manager, for example, which is a design document, I can see all these different requests that are here, the full design OpenAPI spec here, which is great and lets me hit the ground running when I'm joining a team. It lets me collaborate better with my team members as well. And further, if the rest of the team is building, you know, new services or creating these API collections for new services, I have this option here to just pull these collections. So I can pull vitals right now, for example, which looks like it's just getting started, just has a couple of calls, and there's definitely more to come here, but also has, you know, documentation associated with it, which, you know, also is just getting started for the purposes of this demo. But we're really, you know, excited about this opportunity to help you organize your APIs and bring some better productivity to you as well. But now let's jump into the roadmap and see where we're going next. So the first thing I want to talk about is the Insomnia plugin platform. And we already have many great Insomnia plugins that the community is using and has developed over time. We're really excited about more to come. We actually have a, if you're not aware, we have a summit hackathon, a Kong Summit hackathon going on right now. And one of the categories is best Insomnia plugin. And that closes at, I believe, midnight tonight Pacific time. So definitely still time to get hacking and create a great Insomnia plugin. There's some awesome prizes as well. So quick plug for that. But over time and as we move into next year, we're really excited to kind of reinvigorate this plugin platform. And some reasons for that, we're seeing that, you know, users love Insomnia. All of you love Insomnia because it's really simple. You know, we think simplicity is one of the key tenets for how we want to build Insomnia going forward. But at the same time, you know, we get lots of feature requests, which those of you on engineering teams or product teams will definitely know that story very well. And we know we need to keep up with a rapidly evolving industry. You know, I was mentioning earlier adding gRPC support and saying, you know, WebSockets and MQTT and other protocols that are coming out, not to mention many other features unrelated to protocols that we'll need to add over time as well. And so we really need to figure out how to add these features, keep up with the evolving industry and landscape without necessarily creating an airplane cockpit with bells and whistles and dials all over the place. And we really think that that's where plugins can come into play for all of you to help with the situation. And so really what we want to do is be able to take plugins to the next level, offer you more APIs, more hooks into Insomnia to make more interesting plugins that are more valuable and more useful for your use cases. And we really think that that will provide sort of an opt-in complexity for users. They can say, well, I'm developing GraphQL, but not actually gRPC, for example. So maybe they can have a set of those plugins and not have to worry about the noise that comes with all of the other protocols that they may not use. It's stuff like that. So they're really able to craft Insomnia in the user interface there to match what they need from that tool. And then we also think that will start a flywheel of innovation. So where more plugins being built will solve more use cases. More use cases mean more users can use the tool to get the job that they need done. And those new users will bring more needs, more ideas, and that will generate more plugins as well. And the cycle will continue. So we're really excited about continuing this innovation, again, helping you stay at that forefront of technology as well. So look out for that next year. And if you have ideas or want to reach out to us about how this might work, definitely feel free. So the next feature we're gonna look at is pluggable automation workflows. And you know, speaking of plugins, we also wanted to bring this to the Inso command line tool, which I mentioned earlier. So again, the Inso command line tool is really the workhorse for these API ops workflows. And we've heard some problems with that as well. So, you know, each organization, namely, will have slightly different standards that they want to enforce. Nobody necessarily uses all the same ones. They may have different alerting needs or different deployment environments that they need to operate and orchestrate deployments to, et cetera. So really what this comes down to is that today there's lots of custom scripts, there's lots of manual work that needs to be integrated into these pipelines and workflows, which sort of goes against that core principle of API ops of automation, automation, automation. So what we really wanna do here is provide hooks into that automation system, into Inso itself, to help you write code or use other plugins to really get what you need done. And, you know, offering templates for common editions. So one of the things that we've heard a lot is these custom linting policies that you want to enforce around an OpenAPI spec. So that's one of the things that we're going to be looking at targeting earlier on. But really with this kind of plugins for Inso, we want to offer more of that end-to-end API ops story. So definitely excited about that. Next is IDE integrations. So again, problems we're hearing from our community is that switching between different tools and contexts can be pretty burdensome. Switching between your writing code, building an API, and then, oh, you need to go test this thing or call out to this API or write some design spec and tabbing out to go to Insomnia, maybe copy pasting something back over to VS Code. That's both tedious and error prone in a lot of cases. And we're also seeing, you know, increasingly more and more work being done within that IDE, really starting to actually live up to its name of that integrated development environment where it can do kind of everything. Of course, that's not for everybody. Personally, I still like doing Git commands in my terminal, for example, but a lot of people really get a lot of value from that. And certainly I'm seeing in myself a lot of value from and save time savings from not doing that. So we really want to start experimenting with an Insomnia IDE extension and potentially, you know, multiple. Our goal with that is really to make development for you all more efficient. It'll help eliminate the need for that context switching and get the API development kind of closer to where the rest of the development is happening within that IDE. So again, something to look out for next year. And again, if you have feedback or questions about that, happy to answer and hear any suggestions as well. So with that, that's all the time that I have in the presentation.